Good morning. This video is going to be about the dual c830 cassette player I purchased not too long ago. It's from I think the late 70s, maybe 78 79, when this was very popular, from Germany, which is for that time was kind of like something being made in America. Most everything was made in China and Japan. But this is the video because it's time for this thing to have the belts replaced on it. It has problems playing when it's cold. When it's cold, the winding does not turn. The rewind also is very sluggish. It's a sign that the belts are getting worn out. It is, what, 35, 40 years old, so we're gonna go ahead and I ordered them online. There's like 5 belts total, and we're gonna tackle this. I don't think it'll be too difficult, especially if I record everything as I go along. It's gonna be hard to undo if I make any mistakes, so this is the starting. First thing we need to do is remove all the panels. I've already somewhat cleaned this unit fairly well and took some pictures inside when I first bought it. There was a little sign of belt defragmenting. Not really bad, but that's what I figured to do to now instead of it turning into a mess. So here we go. Okay, so I have the cover off. And you can see here, this is the power supply where the power comes in. And over here is where we're concentrated, where the package of the belts that need to be replaced. Here's one of them. I think this is the counter that counts. Counts the length of the tape over here. Counter. Okay, so that's what that belt runs. It might run something else as well. And then there's the large belt here. It's around this large drive wheel. Here's the motor. I think the motor comes out very easily. I've already unplugged this. Very good. Leave things plugged in when you're working on them. Not only for your own safety, but for the safety of these units. They're sensitive. So we're going to be very careful and document everything that we do. I'm going to turn the light on here. I'm going to do that real quick. Yeah, so I might show you some of the condition of these belts. Let me get closer here. The one in the back there is the one I think is the one that's slipping. You can see it's a little shiny. You can see the light shining on it, and it's giving reflection. That's because the outside is oxidized, and I can try to clean it. I have a rubber rejuvenator, but the belts are so old that most likely it would remove that, but it would stretch it and it wouldn't run properly. So we're going ahead and replace and lubricate. You can also see pulleys and the plastic wheels look in relatively good condition, not too yellow, so that's good news. And there's little places that we're going to put in some oil around the capstan bushings and bearings and things like that. So well, let's get started on this. Okay, so the first thing we need to remove is this piece. It looks like there's 1, 2, 3 screws. This should pull off. I'm not sure. I think this might come with it. And then the motor just comes off by very gently twisting. Okay, so we removed the triangle bushing bearing. So here's the flywheel and its bearing. And inside there, there's the capstan. That's what drives the capstan. If I go on the other side over here, you can see, there is it right there. So that piece, you can see that washer as I pull. I'm going to pull on the actual other side. You can see it wiggling. So we're going to have to remove that washer. Make sure it doesn't fall in there. There's the capstan roller right below it. So we're going to take that off and gently pull this out. Now remember, when you're pulling it out, it's going to be tricky getting it back in because it's such a small hole. But just hopefully things will be. Gently wiggle it back and forth. It'll come. Don't drop it. There we go. Got it. Okay. Oh. Don't drop it. Okay. So very important piece not to forget to put back on. That's with after we oil the capstan bearing and bushing. This will kind of help keep the oil inside where it belongs. So I'm gonna put all my screws in a cup here so we don't lose anything. Drop that in there. Here's a big belt. See, it's not too bad. I'm wondering if this has been done once before, but it's glazed. So just before it starts turning into tar. Okay, here's a close up on the motor's bearing. It's not too bad. And down there you can see that's that belt is what rides on this, so I'm going to go down in there and pull that out. Oops. Okay, let's see what this one looks like. Excuse me. Okay, I'm going to leave those in the bag, but we'll take a closer look when we pull them out. So, and over here I'm just going to take a piece of tape and mark which is the old belt. There's the this drive belt is the one that went around this pulley here, and then up here it connects to this pulley at the top, but from underneath here, so that goes basically around like that up in there. So okay, so we won't forget that's where that belt comes from. Set down and mark that. Okay, I was able to get the flywheel capstan bushing. Oh, this is the bearing actually. I was able to get it out without taking out those screws. And you can see the surface here. We're gonna clean that really well. It's got a little glaze on it with alcohol, 99 or 98%, whatever you can find. Don't get the cheapness, 78%. Has a lot of water in it, cause corrosion possibly so. So anyway, we got that out, luckily. Be very careful wiggling it. Oh, I had to do that. What I had to do is take the two wires, the blue and white wire that were in front, I just tucked them underneath, behind the flywheel, and continued to wiggle it a little bit. It came right out, so. And you can see there's some grease back in here that we're gonna have to clean and re-lube. And it's still pretty pliable. So, doesn't look too bad. And there's the bushing that we're going to want to really clean real well. Yes. Okay. So I've removed the wiring, got everything out of the way here. Kind of just lay it out. Something to protect everything internally. Don't want to damage anything because this is all the area that we're going to be working on. And I don't want to drop any screws down in there, so they'll fall on the t-shirt, which is what I'm hoping for. So I'm going to go ahead and remove and clean these little washers and bearings and go from there. By the way, the tools you'll need is a screwdriver, a little small like these little jewel screwdrivers come handy. Again, the alcohol and some lint-free rags. I usually like to use cotton or these microfiber tiles work real good too. So that's what I'm going to be cleaning everything with today, with the alcohol. So there you go. Got a 3-4 cats in our backyard deciding they want to have a little fight rumble. Look at this. Yeah, get lost. It's a white one. Think they're all brothers and sisters? Okay, so these three things right here are not pulleys. They're just to hold the motor in place, or bushings, basically. They're rubber bushings. So you don't need to take those off. I'm just going to clean them up with a little alcohol and a Q-tip. Make sure they're clean and not falling apart, which you seem to still be pliable, so that's good. So I'm going to now move into removing and cleaning the gears and pulleys over here. I already cleaned the capstan bearing. It's all been cleaned. Take the bearing off. This has been cleaned. We're going to lubricate this with that machine oil. This right here, that's what you lubricate with the cap scan. That's the only thing you use on that bearing. Okay, so let's move on. Okay, so right here, there's a little switch that we need to clean with deoxic. This little piece right here. The two contacts will open and close. We're going to clean those contacts, the deoxic, and then gently wipe it out with alcohol. Okay, so now we've done the cleaning of this pulley, lubricated a little bit on the shaft with some of that lube, and then here at the points that need grease, we put in some nice fresh silicone grease. So at this point here, and I need to get back in here still. You can see back in there, there's some grease. We're gonna clean that up and put some of that fresh grease in there as well. Then to take this wheel off, we need to take off on the other side that drives this piece. So there is a little C-clip right inside there we need to remove. Take this off, and I'm hoping that gear will come off by doing that. So that's what I'm going to do next. And then here is the capstan bearing. Make sure that's really clean and lubed well, without any excess anywhere else. These are the pieces that wind the tape, so pay very attention to them, putting them back on, and not forget to get the washer. So that goes right on here. Okay, and the same thing on this side. It looks like I'm going to have to take this plate off to find out what's holding the other that gear on. So I need to take that gear off to be able to get to that last belt, it looks like. So I'm going to have to remove this. I think I'm going to have to remove this outer piece. All the knobs have to come off. So I'll be doing that next. That's just three screws on the top and probably on the bottom as well. So I'm going to do that next. Take a second or two. Okay, so I took the front off. We're going to try to take this plate off here now. Just pay attention here. There's a spring right here and how it goes back on. That's how it's back on. Goes in a little onto that little groove right there. There's only a one of them, so pay attention to that and other lubing spots that we can see here are right in here. We can clean that up, lube it. Here's our pinch roller we can clean real good. I have some rubber renew. The head on this is really in good shape, so don't need much attention into this area. Looks like 1, 2, 3, Four screws might take everything out, so let's try to do that first. We can drop it down. See? It's like 1, 2, 3, 4. Start with that, see what happens. Okay, so I've worked it off of this pulley up here, cleaned the pulley really well. It's super important to clean every little bit of contamination from the old belts off. If you don't, you're going to regret it later. So, unless you're selling this and then someone is not going to be too satisfied later down the line. So, let's get that belt off. Okay, so I was able to get that one gear in there. It was really a bear. It took me about a half an hour. It's easier if you take out the four screws, take the front off, and be able to work on it on your bench. The only thing is you have to break the wires loose from their harnesses to do that. That's what I did. You can see, I'm just set to make sure we plug everything back in and put everything back together. So there's this one lever right here that I have to put the screw back in. Whoops, sticky. So we're gonna do that next. Okay, we have all of the new pulleys in. Everything is back the way it was. All the lubrication points here, and right in there, right here. A little bit on there, a little bit there. Of course, the capstan, all of the pulleys that we needed to. Motor is set back in place properly. We're ready to put on the front. So I'm gonna do that next. Okay, put all the screws back in. Just have to put on the knobs over there, knobs. Everything is back together the way it was. Good thing is there's only four screws left. Those are going to the cover, so we know we didn't lose anything or we didn't forget to put anything back on. So now we just need to keep our fingers crossed and hopefully it works. So do that next. Okay, so I plug it in and it looks like play works. Nice and quiet, nice and quiet. Very good. Look at the speed on that. Should be good. Let's put the cover on. We'll plug it in and we're good to go. We're going to put these rest of these knobs on. Okay, moment of truth. Have it all back where it was. Start it up. That's a good sign. Everything opens up, closes. The tape. Go. Keep your fingers crossed. They're turning.
I'm a fool to when you treat me this way. I know I love you, but what can
sounds
I
awesome.
Do? I'm a fool to care.
So there you go, all brand new belts, works like a champ. Thanks for watching. Subscribe and all those other things to make you want to watch. Have a nice day, stay safe, behave yourself.